Who would have guessed that when Rocket League released 5 years ago, that it would become the game it is today? With an ever-growing esports scene and a freshly announced year-long tournament worth $4.5 million in prize money. Before I begin, welcome back to the channel. I have returned after taking a short break and I'm ready to make some more content for you guys. And as a way to kick things off again, I thought there'd be no better way than to discuss the future of this game as it has just hit its 5-year anniversary, as well as off the back of some huge announcements and teasers from Psyonix. So, we are currently in the middle of the 5th anniversary in-game event, which will see the return of Spark Rush and Heatseeker, as well as balloon collectibles that can be put towards buying in-game event items and golden egg crates. Despite having the worst crate luck of all time, I managed to get Zombers for my last egg on stream. Just wish I had a face cam for my reaction.
Got in yonks. Oh, exotic. Exotic. I got zombies! Yes! Just normal. Yes. Ah, yes. Yes.
Anyway, so if you haven't already, be sure to jump on and check the event out and grind the balloons, because they will only be out for a limited time. Now in some much bigger news. Psyonix has announced that they are making new ranks above Grand Champ and potentially changing the entire rank system for next season. In their community post, they said that they are doing work that includes changes to competitive play, such as new ranks for players at Grand Champion. So, before we continue, what would you all like this to be? What sort of names do you think would be good for these new ranks? Personally, I believe the ranks should be extended up to and beyond 2000 MMR, with ranks dedicated especially to the top 100 worldwide and in each region, as it will provide the higher players with some purpose and motivation to keep grinding and improving. This could also mean that competitive could be getting a complete overhaul, which is long overdue, such as that which happened a few years ago, when the system we have now was introduced. It seems extremely promising, and the fact they've delayed Season 15 and Rocket Pass 6 in order to work towards a big update highlights it could be a real game changer and cause many players to come back to it if they do it right. Also in this post, they announced the Season 14 rewards, which is going to be player banners. It is a bit of a change up from the usual boost, wheels, decals or goal explosions that we've seen in the recent seasons, but I have to say I don't mind it. It's very simple, clean and something people will actually use, as unlike decals and wheels, people care less about the rarity and look of their banner, but rather its status, and this delivers just that. There's also the standard titles for Grand Champ in every mode, so with the extra time given and if you're close, be sure to try and get your Grand Champ rewards ASAP. In other massive news, Psyonix has announced the new esport format and scene. They've essentially dumped the old RLRS and RLCS formats in favour of RLCS-X. Essentially, RLCS-X is a year-long tournament consisting of 3 seasons with 3 divisions in each region, NA, EU, OCE and South America. In each season, there is 3 regional events where teams gather points through different and unique formats, so I assume just not 3v3 like normal, to qualify for the international major for that season, where the best teams from each region battle it out for a prize pool of $250,000. Also note that one regional event has as much money as a DreamHack tournament has, and there are 6 of them each season, so 18 in total. After the 3 seasons have been played, the 16 teams with the most points and wins qualify through to the World Championship with a $1 million prize pool, which will be similar to the RLCS that we know at the moment. Even if you're still confused after that brief explanation of the format, and to be honest, I still am as well, it's not that hard to see that this is the biggest pro event that we have seen in Rocket League history. It combines RLCS, RLRS, and all other pro events into one massive multi-season event, and I'm super excited to learn more about how it all works, and even better, the effect it will have for Rocket League's popularity and mainstream success. So, that just about wraps it up guys, and if you're still here, thanks for dropping by and showing some support. My normal style videos will return soon, so if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe to be alerted for any future uploads and streams. I hope you all enjoyed this update and the latest announcements and look into the future of Rocket League, and I wish you all a splendid day. Cheers.